be like, so this is actually a three variable k-map which will be modified to two variables because we are going to consider only two inputs, A and B. Now there are only two bits, A and B, and we will put up this final output into the k-map. So for AB, the output as this is position number 0, 1, 2, 3. So for position number 0, that is AB 0, 0, the output is 1. So I will put here 1. Then at position 1, the output is 0. Position 2, output is again 1. And position 3, output is C. So here is the special case that C is mapped into the k-map. That's why it is called as mapped entered variable, MEV, or and this process is called as variable entered mapping. So it's a SOAP form, so I will enter 1 in the k-map. So let us form a group of 2. So there will be a group of 2 here, and the equation y will be equal to, for these two group, a bit is not common, b bit is common to the leftwards, it will be b bar. And if we make another group of these two, c with 1, so C bit is also present, 1 bit is also present. If you go straight upwards, A bit is there, and go leftwards, B bit is not common. So I will take A as the MSB bit A, and it is coming with C. That's why this will be A C. So what are the expression finally we got here? That is the same expression here we got, but it's a two variable k-map. So what is the advantage of variable entered mapping? You can reduce the k-map by one of its variable, particularly the LSB bit. Here in this case, C is the LSB bit. So you can easily convert 5 variable k-map into 4 variable k-map with the help of variable entered mapping. So this is a very helpful method to reduce the logical expression. And thank you for watching in 5 minutes. And that's all about the variable entered mapping. Thank you.